Many leading Republicans and conservatives want someone other than Donald Trump to run for president in 2024. They say we need someone with Trump's virtues, but without his vices. Fair enough. But this formulation does not get us very far unless we have a proper accounting of his virtues. Other Republicans say some version of, I like Trump's policies, but I don't like the rest of him. This gets it almost backwards. Although Trump advanced many important policies, it is the rest of him that contains the virtue that inspires the movement. Trump was born for the current crisis, the life and death struggle against a totalitarian enemy I call woke communism. The woke comms clench the Democratic Party by the scruff of its neck. They tell us lies, and they silence those who challenge the lies. Like most totalitarian regimes, they have a scapegoat, white males. They have a narrative. America is systemically racist. And they have a utopian vision of society where all identity groups are equal in all areas of American life. The woke comms control all the cultural and economic powers in America, from where they ruthlessly push their agenda. That agenda rests on the conviction that America is bad. As Trump once said, their goal is not to make America better. Their goal is to end America. Make no mistake, we are in the midst of a cold civil war. Trump awakened the public to this fact. You cannot win a war unless you know you are in one. Trump's critics say he caused or exacerbated the divide in this country. No, he didn't. He revealed, not caused, an existing divide. In war, you must make a stand. For that, we need strong men. Weak men do anything to avoid admitting the hardest truth because they lack the resolve to do what truth demands of them. Trump is a manly man. In present time, when manhood is being stripped of its masculinity, traditional manhood, even when flawed, is absolutely essential.